Welcome back to the channel. It's your sister from another Mr. Lovely Fly Shy, and I am back with another one. I hope all is well with each and every one of you. That is always my sincerest hope and pleasure to all of my dear and near to my heart subscribers. I really and truly appreciate all of you. I know that one of the biggest challenges for me on this channel particularly is remaining consistent because of just the many and different changes that have been going on in my life. So many things just taken off very abruptly for me, very, very quickly. And so, yeah, but I'm here today in front of you all, before you all, to share this vlog. I kind of wanted to give you guys an inside scoop, a little peep into my life and kind of what my day-to-days look like. What do I do to ground myself? What do I do to ensure that I am, you know, operating on my highest level of frequency and vibration? And also just wanted to kind of come on here and talk to you guys about other stuff. So I'm gonna grab this camera, we gonna walk, and we gonna talk. Stay tuned. Alrighty, you all, welcome back. Greetings and salutations to all of my good people out there. So yeah, like, where do I start really? You guys, life, the level of spiritual warfare, you know, the attacks and just everything that's going on, everything that's been going on, you know, everything that I was prepared and or being prepared for a very long time is now taking place. You know, it's now taking precedence in my life. You know, many of you didn't know this, but I actually moved. I finally gained the courage to leave Las Vegas. And number one, I haven't talked about this, but, you know, I want to share my journey with you all. So it only makes sense to be transparent, authentic, and real with you all. I want to share with you all with you guys, the ups, the downs, the happies, you know, the frowns, the mistakes, the achievements, the wins, the losses, all of it, right? And so I gained the courage by the grace of God to finally leave Las Vegas, because one day I had been getting the inkling, of course, and I was being highly encouraged by the divine to get the hell out of there, all right? Because what I seen in a vision was that that place was going to be my inevitable demise, y'all. If I had stayed on the path that I was on, around the, it's about, you know, it's all environmental, you all. Whereas it's mental, it's environmental, right? And if you're around people that are not only not woke, but are walking amongst us as if nothing is going on here, as if everything is everything, right? As if they don't see what's going on, right? Especially within mainstream media and the propaganda and so on and so forth here, right? But the fact of the matter is, collective, and what I'm trying to get to is, I just knew it was time in terms of my evolutionary process to, again, get the hell away. And I'm already prepared for some of the ramifications to come for that, or as a result of me, you know, choosing to make the best decision possible at the time for myself and children. But I'm already prepared in terms of, you know, my ex, my children's dad, and everything else that I shut the door to. I'm already prepared for, you know, what's to come in regards of that. You know, it can go one or two ways. It can be, we can all, you know, work together. We can kind of agree to disagree and come to a cohesive understanding, mostly, because when it involves the kids, you know, and when it involves protecting their sanity, protecting their future, and protecting their emotional, mental, physical, and so on and so forth. Because hell, I didn't want my kids to grow up like me, you all. I'm just gonna let you know, plain and simple. You know, whenever the Most High tells me it's time and the Most High tells me to move, I'm going to move, especially if my kids are attached to it, right? And they are. And so just moving, I'm not gonna say just where, I'm not gonna say where, that is just for safety reasons, of course, but just moving on a limb, basically. Just God gave me the vision. God put certain things in place. He prepared the table. He set up everything in order for me to go. And y'all, let me tell you, I'm gonna try to include some clips also of like the trip and everything. But yeah, like y'all, there were so many, the devil was trying to hold on to us so bad. There were so many different blockages that was happening on our way to where we are now. Like, but we're gonna get into that. We're gonna get into that. But thankfully, needless to say, everything is kind of calming down. There is another, I won't say battle as if, like in a negative aspect, but there's other things that I'm battling as well, in conjunction with making this huge move. Because when the devil knows, when the enemy knows that this breakthrough is near and that you were obedient to the Most High and everything that is to follow and come as a result of your obedience, oh, that enemy is going to try to make your life a living hell, you guys. I'm telling you. I've been dealing with things, and I'm just like, whew. The enemy is trying to test me in all areas of my life. Financially, mentally, emotionally, physically. Another big testy part. I fucked around and hurt myself, y'all. So I was walking down the stairs. This was like, this happened on August 1st because I had my daughter take a picture of my back when it happened. But yeah, it happened on August 1st. And I was just hastily walking down the stairs. You know, I don't know if it was just the excitement of everything or my nerves or what. And I messed around, and them last two, three steps, I felt like I missed them and jumped up damn there and hit my back. I'm not exaggerating. That shit hurts so bad. Y'all, excuse my language. I'm trying to whisper it because my kids, all eyes and ears is open, child. But anyways, but I'm okay. But I do feel like I dislocated my hip, y'all. But all bullshit aside, I am going to go get that taken care of. Come tomorrow. I just have so many things to do. Like, I did not realize, you guys, how stressful moving was or is, like, in the process of everything. Like, once I packed up my apartment back in Vegas, everything got thrown away, and I got over the initial shock of, oh, I'm finally moving. Like, I didn't tell nobody, actually. I just did it because I felt like if I told anyone, something terrible was going to happen to mess up my plans and hold me back. Because after having my relapse and all of so many other things that I'm gonna have to share with you all someday in the near future, and probably some upcoming story times, but everything that was going on out there, like, I was, man. And the sad part is, I had had that stretch of time where I was good. I had created my second channel. Although I didn't reach my success at the brink of my relapse that fast, but once I started gaining that momentum and that success and all of that, and it's still going, you know, I was like, oh, hell no, I'm not going to stay here, stay in the very place that has kept me stuck for X, Y, and Z, you know? Naraya, get over here. So, yeah, when you got your kiddos, I gotta, like, multitask. I gotta, like, watch them like a hawk, you know? But, anyways, so, yeah, like, it was so many things happening, y'all, and God was just giving me so many signs. He was like, if you don't leave, something bad is gonna happen. Like, I could just feel the impending doom, literally, you guys. Like, I just felt like if I didn't leave, something terrible was gonna happen. And then everything else, like I said, we got some story times for days. Like, earlier this year, y'all, I went through a whole ass custody battle. I didn't have to deal with being departed and separated for from my girls for a length of time, all due to a narcissistic personality who just wants to be in control, who wants to be right about everything. And like, I'm just at a point where I'm just like, I don't even care to even, like, I just, the reason why I'm guided to share my stories is because I know other people is going through it when it comes to narcissistic abuse and going through custody battles and things like that. But because of how blessed I am, because of how abundant I am, because of what God has brought me through, man, like, I don't even care to keep bringing him up, bringing the situations up at all, like, period, you know? But I'm just like, it is what it is, you know? And as I'm sitting here talking to y'all, and I'm just kind of just reflecting as I'm thinking and venting to you all, it's just, a lot has changed, y'all. Like, I really moved. I really left a place that I thought I would never escape, you know? And don't get me wrong, there are days where I'm like, damn, I miss Vegas. But then I think about everything that has come thus far, ever since making that huge, you know, that huge step and taking that huge step of faith. Like, everything has looked up, you know? Are things perfect because I moved? No. But now I have, like, clarity. I have a better sense of, you know, direction. I know what it is that I really need to do. But then let me tell you all this. Here comes the enemy, all right? Because the enemy knows that, once again, at any given moment, when the Most High says it's time to move, or, you know, we want you here, or you got to be there, and the enemy knows that we are going to move and we are going to follow the Most High's instruction. So you guys can notice that in your walk or in your journey, you know, people could begin to act funny. Like, that's one of the biggest things that I'm going through right now. People just continuously showing their true colors, showing me why I had been right all along to pull back my energy, take my power back, and completely X them and disregard them out of my life. That's not to say that I hate these individuals. That's not to say that I wish anything bad upon them. In fact, some of them I still actually care about, still actually love. But when it comes to my energy, when it comes to my power, I can't let you have that. I gotta cut them cords on that. My energy, my magic, my power, it's way too strong. It's way too powerful for just anybody to have it. All right? And I say that with all God's humbleness that he has equipped me with, you all, respectively. But sorry if I sound out of breath. I'm just talking and venting with y'all. But I don't know. Like, I literally took that leap of faith the whole time when I was on my way to, you know, where I'm at. I was just like, I'm really doing this. Like, I'm really doing this, y'all. And I'm telling you, things may not be perfect, but they are changing. And I know that there's more to come. And I'm just going to accept that, accept where I am, and be grateful for it all. All right, y'all. Peace. One more thing, y'all, before I mess around and forget. Do not be afraid to move. Do not be afraid to step out on faith, step out of your comfort zone, and relocate. You know, do not be afraid of it, because that is what the enemy most wants you to do, wants you to stay stuck, complacent, boggled down, you know. And those who once had access to you, that's what they want as well. You know, if they can control you, if they can control your you know, your movement, so to speak, and you know, how far you can go or how far you can get because of their refusal to just, you know, play fair, or their refusal, or whatever the case is, right? The list can go on, but all I'm saying, all in all, is just do not be afraid to move. Don't be afraid to cut people off, whether it's family or whatever. We talked about that a lot on this channel, y'all. But it's getting even more serious when it comes to protecting the vision, you know, protecting the product, okay? Protect, you know, which is you, right? So it gets deep. It gets deep, y'all. But I'm over here sweating like crap. It is so freaking humid here. So humid. But it is absolutely beautiful. Yeah, y'all, I did something new with my hair. I'm starting my little natural hair journey. by like 6 to 8 months, your girl want to have some like hang time. I want to be able to just shape my dreads. They ain't dreads, they mini braids, by the way. But yeah, peep the mini braid action. Ooh, child, who helped me take these out though? I'm serious, like.